We started class one when we were so many. By the time we were in class six, literally, so many had been married. My best friend got married in class six. Now, looking back, and I see how much girls suffer and girls' potentials are left behind. And it's not just then, it still continues up to today. So because of the experience I had as a young girl, because of going through FGM, because of being at the brink of getting married, and because of seeing how other women were treated in my community, I was able to get an opportunity to go to school beyond what most women in my community did. And that really, going to college, opened up my world and my, my eyes. And, I feel that I had a responsibility to reach out to women in my community. So education has been the key. Because education did provide me the pathway to the person I am today. I'm helping young women in my community go to school. We have a girls' school in primary and secondary, and really providing scholarships and opportunities so that they can dream, so that they can be children, so that they can follow their path. I'm looking for equality for girls. We are all humans, and just because you're a girl, you shouldn't be treated as a second-class citizen. So equality in everything. So equality in choice to go to school, equality to pursue your dreams, equality to decide when you want to get married and to who you want to get married to equality if you want to have children, and equality if you want to go to work. And having that choice to decide and to choose your own path is very powerful. And so that's, I think, the education for me plays a big role, because it gives people liberations. It also gives people the knowledge to know what is out there. It opens up their horizons. Tradition shouldn't harm, tradition should build. It should be something that's celebrated. But when you see some of this injustice and things that happen to girls, it's human rights. It's like violations of their lives and their rights. It's so sad to still see girls being forced to undergo female genital cutting. You don't end the traditions by just implementing the laws. You really have to get on the ground and really educate people about the harmful practices that are happening.